12 months.
We have not changed. Yes.
You have not changed.
We have not changed.
In the launch of
the only issue is that we had three elections or two elections. There's a whole process that really derailed a lot of the plans and things.
So the period when we were campaigning, you want us to remove that from how we judge you and then start now.
We have a new mandate. Let's start now.
Well, we have seen a platform late in terms of its rollout. Some say, in terms of how it was also launched, it was confused with other international platforms, Elance or Desk. Locally, we have Kuhustle and the like. Did Ajira initially face problems of catching on because there was confusion with what it does and all these other platforms, whether locally or internationally? Was that a challenge?
It was a challenge because people first did not understand that it's an information. It's not that you go to Ajira and get the jobs.
Whose fault was it that they did not understand?
It's a new thing. When you introduce a new thing, Kenyans didn't understand SMS even at the beginning, if you remember. It's not to say that there's a problem. When you introduce something new, then it takes time. Now Kenyans SMS more than people in New York. So it doesn't mean that if you start slow, that it's a bad thing. It's just that people haven't done it before. And you know, if you remember at the time, people are working from home, and their parents are saying, enda kazini. The guys are saying, no, we are earning here. Others are thinking that they're involved in the illicit stuff. So now it's a time where you let everybody know, actually, there is work that people do on their computers. And it actually earns real money. There's opportunities that you can do overseas. You know, so whereas to you and I may have been quick to understand, not everybody understands it quickly. So again, it took us time to get everybody to that phase to understand. Even the companies that need to also start putting their jobs online so that people can work. Also, those ones have taken time.
Okay.
But I think we're at a place where Kenyans are ready. I mean, if you look at even on blockchain and how people have adopted that area. So we have a whole group of people who are on the cutting edge. Then we have some that are not.
Who need to catch
and
up.
And we need to bring everyone there.
I'll be coming to you to talk about blockchain technology shortly. But let's talk about the digital literacy program. In 2013 Jubilee, very clear. One laptop for every Standard 1 student.
Correct.
Over the next five...
In the public schools.
In the public schools. Okay.
Right. Yes.
The figures show that that has not yet happened.
It happened. That happened. That happened.
That happened.
We've gone over
despite
already...
Despite the delay in the rollout and the tendering and the re-tendering,
that
you can assure
clear,
us
yes?
that right now every public Standard 1 student joining public schools has a laptop.
Well, no, the ones that were there. So we've already given, they've been put in labs. So the new ones coming in would use those labs. Whether the schools say they're moving those kids to the next one with labs,
okay,
that's a different thing. But we have the second phase, which we are in the process of also rolling out. The challenge we had at the beginning is that we had said we were going to assemble this locally. It took too long for the assembly, so we allowed imports to come in. This next round, we would like as much as possible this to be produced locally. So we import the parts, but we assemble. So Jomo Kenyatta University, Moi University, they've already got the assembly lines and they're starting to produce. The speed is not as fast. And this is for phase two. This is for the second. The first one we have actually been able to deliver.
Okay.
We would like to take that all the way to standard 8. So it's not a one-off project that you finish and that's it. We want to continue.
Again, and I think no one is against the idea. We've seen one laptop per child projects across the world. If you just Google one laptop per child, you'll see almost every country seeking to implement. But was it thought out well in terms of its rollout? We're talking about power issues across the country. We're talking about security issues across the country as well. In hindsight, looking back, for someone who has private sector experience at such a high level, could this have been done differently?
You know, I've talked with many of the stakeholders who have been involved in this project. They say it's one of the most ambitious projects they have ever been involved in.
Not over-ambitious?
No, but we delivered. If it was over-ambitious, we would not have delivered. The kids that were there already consumed all the content that KICD had produced. We had to produce more content for them. Teachers today are all asking for further training. They were trained, now they're saying they need more training. In fact, those were the Standard 1 teachers that were trained. All the others are saying they also need to be trained. As in now the demand and need for this, it's fully understood. Whereas before people were saying they don't want this project, now they want to see it expanded, they want to see it growing.
If we find...
It was not too ambitious.
Yes.
You were able to deliver. Yes, you saw people even going with boats to deliver, walking. There was all
even
manner
deliver
of things.
Examination
Yes, we
papers.
Have to, and that shows inclusiveness. I think as a country, we have to be daring. We have to be ambitious to do, you know, big things. We can't say we can only do what we think we can deliver. This one, the president gave his commitment and he pushed us. He pushed us to make sure we deliver, and we delivered, and we delivered on something very ambitious.
But there are those who say that this project showed the gaps in infrastructure when it comes to public schooling across the country. They are not satisfied.
They
say that,
but we have over 20,000 schools that received electricity that did not have before. Over 20,000, I think, out of there's about 500 that don't have electricity now from the last number that I looked at. Mm-hmm. The communities around those schools now have electricity as part of the last mile program. So this program was not only for those tablets and laptops being delivered, it affected the whole community. The people that were involved in all the distribution, those were all jobs created. We had over 8,000 jobs created directly. Indirectly, I think it was more than 15,000 jobs
because of this project. What happened?
And it transformed. We have factories in Eldoret. We have factories in Jomo Kenyatta University that were not there before, employing people on high-tech jobs. It's something that's taken Kenya to another level.
Okay.
Countries are coming for benchmarking with us. We've done well.
I don't disagree.
Yeah.
But when you have students in Nyeri, mm-hmm, being chased away from their school because they don't have money, we read this in the papers. It was a story we did yesterday.
Right.
Because they lacked money for desks, because they don't have money for food, etc. We find it hard to believe you, CS. We do, in that the standardization of infrastructure.
So I never talked about desks, but what I'm saying is...
And maybe you might say this is an education matter.
No, I'm not saying that.
Okay.
We're one government, but we cannot say that because the students in Nairobi have desks, they have everything, so we'll give them laptops. But those who don't have desks, they will not get laptops until they have desks. You know, the fact that you want to equalize, for everybody to be able to have the same facilities, you don't have to have everything all at once. It's not possible. Some of those responsibilities for desks and schools and so on are the county government, not necessarily the national government. But we cannot say we will punish that kid not to have access to a tablet because they don't have XYZ. We will do what we have to do ourselves, and we will continue to push the people responsible for desks, people responsible for health, for all those other things. Because you will say, even when we were doing distribution, there were people who had hunger. There are places that were suffering drought. Now, do we take the laptops or do we give them food? We combined both. But yes, we slowed down a bit on delivering the laptops to them so that they eat. But we did not take away their right to actually have these devices. It's easy for us on this end to feel that it's okay for them not to have because they need food first. But if you talk to them, because I've gone out and I've engaged with all of them, they want to have the same opportunities as any other child. We've now extended this where we're working now with the private sector schools, that they'll also be able to access the same devices at the same price. We've gone now even in distribution of textbooks. I think...
So it's an...